10 Cats does countdown. Sean Luck, John Richardson, Rhod Gilbert, Kevin Bridges, Josie Long, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
To 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, since 1982, the countdown clock has been started more than 66,000 times? If you calculate what that equates to in terms of minutes and hours, you'll find you really need to get out more. The average IQ in the UK is just 102, although that does increase when Joey Essex goes away on holiday. And an arcane term for eyes is winker peeps. Although, if you try telling a girl she's got beautiful winker peeps, it's unlikely your winker peeps will ever see her rubber nubs. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Comedian, writer and TV personality, Sean is one of life's winners, though not on Countdown, obviously. Takes a lot of time and effort to get to know the real Sean, and a degree in criminal psychology wouldn't go amiss.
Keep it coming, I'm loving it, I'm loving it. It's all about me.
Joining Sean tonight, it's Rhod Gilbert. Rhod is from Carmarthen in Wales, so he has a slight advantage in the numbers game, more fingers to count on.
That's one of them. That's one of them. There's plenty more where that came from.
No, fair enough. Up against them this evening is John Richardson. It must be difficult for John's girlfriend to date someone with OCD. Every time she gets turned on, John turns her off again.
The best one you've ever done.
Thank you very much. And John's teammate, Kevin Bridges. Kevin recently performed a comedy gig at a prison in Scotland. At least that's what he told his family. The gig lasted 4 months. Kevin, have you seen Countdown before?
Yes, I'm a massive fan.
Really?
I'm a massive fan of 8 out of 10 Cats as well, so can you imagine my reaction? I'm a huge, huge fan. Anybody who's ever been unemployed in their life is a massive Countdown fan.
Were you good at school?
I used to panic at exams in English. I remember one time I forgot how to spell the word who. Under the pressure. I don't have dyslexia or anything, I was writing who, and I just started to overthink it a wee bit. I'm trying to raise awareness that kids are under extreme pressure in exams these days and they're forgetting to spell words like who.
I agree with you, though. I think school goes on way too long. You know, for me, once I'd learnt all the animal noises, I was ready to go out there and get a job and use this stuff.
Sean, how do you get in the zone to play Countdown?
I don't call it zone, Jimmy. I call it a mood. I have to get in a mood. I won't lie to you. I don't like doing Countdown. Why lie? What's the point of lying? I feel like a polar bear trapped in a tiny cage. Up and down, up and down. Why do I have to play Countdown? Why? No, but seriously, I hate playing Countdown. If there are any traditional viewers of Countdown watching, I'd just like to say, well done making it to January.
John, you're up against Rhod tonight. He's undefeated.
Yeah.
You think you can take him?
Well, it's tense. I've won 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdowns. And the only people that have beaten me are Sean and Rhod.
Unfortunately, because I am unbeaten on this, they keep pairing me with this fucker.
I never thought that was my nickname. I thought it was like Spexy, Lockie, Locko, but no, it's this fucker.
Rhod, have you brought a mascot with you?
Yeah, I've got my mascot. I've got my lucky number here, somewhere. There it is, the old lucky number. It's always just been lucky for me, this number. Some people have got 7, some people have got 13. I got 0770090. Hopefully that'll come good tonight.
Isn't that a mobile phone number?
People do say that, yeah.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. One of my big problems with this show is the clock. I don't trust it. I don't think it's accurate. I don't think it gets close to 30 seconds. So I got in touch with the guys at CERN, you know, the Hadron Collider. Yeah. I said to them, I need a timepiece that's nuclearly accurate, that's the most perfect representation of 30 seconds it is capable. And sure. They went away in the lab, some of the world's finest physicians and technicians on the planet, and they came up with this. And that, when I set this, when it goes off... it's 30 seconds. I'm not working to that mofo. I'm working to this baby here.
John and Kevin, have you brought mascots?
Yeah, I brought my mascot. Yeah.
I've got a mascot.
You got a mascot?
That's my mascot. It's a train ticket. I never realised it was locked, but without this train ticket, I would not be here tonight. So. I was presented with barriers and this thing got me through. It was well.
How did they know you had an STD?
Good fun. John, did you bring a mascot?
No, mascots are to bring luck, and luck is for the weak. So I've brought brain food. This is all I eat now. Sushi. Do you want some? Makes you clever.
Is that a dig?
It's brain food, anyway. It's there if ever I need it. If the clock starts and there's 5 seconds left and I haven't got a word...
Yeah, leave some raw fish under some lights for a while, see what happens. What could possibly go wrong? OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Josie Long! Being a brilliant comedian, Josie is a massive Doctor Who fan. So to all the Doctor Who fans watching, look, a girl! Josie, you've got a degree in English from Oxford.
I do.
Does that make you better at Countdown?
No, because that is nothing to do with what you do in the degree. Like, you don't show up at tutorials and they go, OK, what's your essay? And you go, I've got a 9-letter essay. That's good. So what I'm saying is, if I'm bad, it's not my fault, it's nothing to do with me. I'm playing along because I like the fact that John's so cocky about it and I feel like we can cheat. There's no way he's going to beat us, so...
Cocky?
Well, okay. What I'm saying is you're going to lose and you're going to lose to us. Fuck them.
That's what happens when you let women sit together.
OK. With Josie, of course, we've got Susie Dent. Now, here's a fun fact. Not a lot of people know this, but Susie Dent shares her birthday with Liam Gallagher. They normally start off at Laser Quest, head to Pizza Hut, and then go back to Liam's for a pyjama party. I've got a question for you, Susie. The word of the year, according to the Oxford English Dictionary in 2013, was selfie. Good choice?
Very good choice. When a word starts to get lots of spin-offs, you know it's made it. And there were lots. There was Belfie, which was a bottom selfie. Elfie, which was a selfie of a small person. Sorry, John.
Did you just apologise to John?
I did.
I didn't expect slams from Dictionary Corner. I've been called a cocky elf in the last
OK, in charge of the numbers is Rachel Riley. Rachel joined Countdown in 2009, aged 22, replacing Carol Vorderman. Yes, Carol Vorderman, we're talking about you. You used to be on the television, on Countdown. That's right, with the numbers. Well, she's fallen back
to
sleep.
Well done making it to January.
Rachel, after all the glamour and glitz of Strictly, how does it feel to be back on Cat Stars Countdown?
Well, it's not. It was a really scary experience having to dance in front of 10 million people, so it's quite nice being the so-called expert on something.
How do I compare to Brucey out of interest as a host?
Well, you're both very nice, very smartly dressed, funny. You both do the little hop thing when you come on. Neither of you's got your own teeth.
OK, that's the way this is going to go. OK. Both teams are competing for this evening. His and hers countdown dressing gowns. OK, time for our first game. John and Kevin, you're to pick the letters.
You pick the letters, I'm going to brain up.
I'll go for a consonant, please. Rachel.
Good choice. Start with L.
L. I know loads of words that have got L. A better start there. I'll go for a consonant again.
N.
A vowel, please.
You look like you're struggling with that, John.
Yeah, if you pick the letters quicker, I probably won't puke during it.
I'll take three more vowels.
I'm not sure what's more understandable, the Scots or that.
I'll take a vowel, please.
A vowel.
I tell you what, I'm feeling pretty brainy.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you. Dean.
See, I can change my accent.
Oh, no, we swapped.
I'll take a consonant as well.
S.
A consonant again, please, Rachel.
Another S.
I better set my timepiece.
A vowel, please. A consonant.
G.
We'll get another vowel in there, just in case it looks ridiculous.
And the last one, O.
And for the first time today, here is the countdown clock. Well, what have you got, Kevin?
Risky four.
A risky four. OK, John?
Oh, what, quite bad stomach cramps.
OK.
Potential diarrhoea. But a seven.
A seven?
The fish is powerful.
Rhod?
I've got six.
Six, OK. And Sean?
I've got a nine, but it's an acronym.
OK. Well, let's hear the four first. Kevin?
Well, I said it was risky because it's product placement. It's Lego.
You should have been out of build on that, really.
I should have been out of build.
Lego. Is Lego in the dictionary?
Trademark, capital L, so we can't have it.
But it's a capital L, if you look at the...
OK, Rhod, what was your six?
Undoes.
Undoes.
Brilliant.
Brilliant.
Well, good.
It's not brilliant, is it?
OK, John, your seven? Thing.
Glossed.
Glossed, I mean, it can be beaten, of course, by a nine-letter acronym.
Just saw it when the letters were back as they originally were. If you could put them back how they were originally.
Is there a word unglossed? Because if there's unglossed, I think I've got a nine.
Unglazed, but not unglossed.
Is there de-ungloss?
De-ungloss?
Yeah, to de-ungloss. When you ungloss, I don't think, fuck it, I quite liked it glossed.
Sean's nine-letter word.
I just saw it there, and I thought, of course, it's the Latvian National Union of Distressed Sheep Shearers exercise and get no, it's not. Oh, no, it's not a G, it's a J. Sorry.
Seven points for John there. OK, Dictionary Corner, could they have done any better?
Yeah, loads better, because we've got an 8.
I had an 8, but I didn't want to look cocky, actually.
So what is the 8-letter word?
Loudness.
How could you ever use loudness in a sentence without sounding like an idiot?
Yeah. I would say, like, there was a certain loudness to Josie's victory celebrations.
On to our first numbers round. OK, Sean, Rhod, your turn to pick the numbers.
Now, what do you normally do? What do you recommend? What's the house recommendation?
For you guys.
There's a system, isn't there? You pick certain numbers, you've got a better chance.
The easiest one is one from the top, I think, and the hardest are 4 from the top or 6 little
ones. Let's have a house one from the top, large one, and then a few nice ones.
OK. One big one and 5 little ones.
You concentrate this. I'm going to try and get this bastard to work. This is your last chance, buddy.
You got 4, 7, 8, 10, 2, and 25. And the target, 739.
And your time starts now.
Cool. I got this one, Sean. Carol? Carol? Yes, draw them on now. Oh, it's a total prick, yeah, I know, yeah. 739 is 25, 2, 10, 8, 7, 4. Yeah. 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 It's
yeah. Okay, your time's up.
Thanks, Carol.
Rhod, what have you got?
739.
Okay, Sean, what have you got?
740.
740, okay, John?
742.
Are you all right with the sushi?
I'm allergic to fish.
Kevin?
I think I've somewhere near there, pretty much.
Have you got 739?
Borderline, mate. Right, hold on. 4 times 7 is 28.
7 to 28.
Don't anybody seen that coming? Times 25.
I think you're screwed already, but we'll carry on.
To make me feel, Rachel.
Sorry, 725.
Then I just need to make 14 out of those numbers. That's got to be done.
Oh no, you need 39.
I was hoping that would come in at 725.
All right, Rhod, 739.
739, yeah.
How did you get it?
Oh, I didn't write it down. I'll ring her back. You can talk to her later and just confirm it. 739 it was.
We've got 739.
Yeah, me too.
Well, hang on, we'll come over to Dictionary Corner in a moment. Sean, let's go through your methodology.
Now, I've realised I've used 4 twice.
You are basically our only hope, John. Stop eating sushi!
I'm hoping I'll work it out for the power of fish. I did 10 times 4.
10 times 4 is 40.
Yeah.
Minus... Minus 2.
Minus 2, 38.
Times by 25.
What do you think that is?
Rachel, you're not a primary school teacher, just tell us.
I'm Rachel.
Yeah, I need to stop eating fish.
So no points for any of our teams there, but Josie?
I haven't got 739 because I forgot that 7 times 10 is not 700.
Rachel, could it be done?
Yeah, I think it was quite a hard one, though. You could have said 25 times 4 is 100, take away the 7 for 93, times that by 8 for 744, and then 10 over 2 is 5 to take away for 739.
OK, so at the end of that round, Sean and Rhod have no points, John and Kevin have 7 points. And here is your teaser. The words are feel Rhod, and the clue is he wants you to own him. That's feel Rhod. He wants you to own him. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were feel Rhod, and the clue was he wants you to own him. It was, of course, Freehold. So, John and Kevin are in the lead. OK, time to mix things up a little bit now. We've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Rhod and John. So, Rhod, your turn to choose.
How many are there altogether?
9.
I was going to say 6 of each. That's wrong.
Shall I just
I think I'm outplaying how you did in maths.
Three or four are the first ones, and then four what are the other ones? Are the other ones?
Dealer's choice. Just chuck some. Dealer's choice.
Okay, we've got EMOTJ. A.
Let's crack on. I've got a game to win.
N.
I want to catch John unawares.
And the last one, I.
And your time starts now. John, what have you got?
A six.
Six.
Rhod?
Well, I don't know, but it's a lot more than six. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
OK, John, what is your...
I literally just put his fish in my mouth and got a seven. But I'll stick with ration, which is what I should have done with all that fish instead of eating.
Rhod, what have you got?
Well, I've got janitor.
Well, I believe that's 7 points to Rhod. Well done. Josie, could that have been beaten in Dictionary Corner?
No, we got janitor, but we did get emoji, which is a nice word, but it's very short. But janitor is the longest word that we got as well. Yeah.
You need a bigger dictionary than that to beat me.
So at the end of that, Sean and Rhod have 7 points. John and Kevin also have seven. Right. Now it's time for Sean and Kevin to go head-to-head. Kevin, your turn to pick the numbers.
Go for one from the top, two from the middle, and three from the lowest of the low.
Right, on it. Five little ones and one big one. And this round is 10, 6, 5, another 10, 1, and 100. And the target, 130.
Your time starts now.
Oh, hang on.
Harder than it looks.
OK, Sean, what have you got?
No, I've got 130. If I could blow snot balloons, I would.
Kevin, what have you got?
132. I sort of panicked and I just added them all up. I get 113, Jimmy. I'm delighted with that.
OK, Sean, do you want to take us through how you did it?
100. 10 plus 10 is 20. It's 120. 1 plus 6 is 7. Take it away.
Lovely. 113.
I actually went for 100 then, plus 10. And then 10 minus 6.
100 plus 10. 10 minus 6 is 4.
And then took away a one, I think.
Yeah.
I've just shown those other ways it can be done.
So that's 10 points to each team. Time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Josie, what have you got for us?
Well, I've got a new word game, right? Because I love to play Scrabble, but this is what I think is a better version of Scrabble, which is you have to make up your own words, but you have to convince the person you're playing with of a definition of those words. So this is a game that me and my housemate genuinely played at the start of this week. And it's called Cult Scrabble. So you can see at the bottom of the board, it just says cult there. but yes, for example, if you look at the board now, there's diarrhea bar, and that is explosive stomach illness at a Mexican street festival. I get that. And the next one is clute, right? But he's only done that because my housemate uses dental floss and flicks it at me. So that's what Clue is.
In my house, that's called pudding.
And then next is my favourite one. That's a souge, which is when you accidentally give yourself a bum massage.
How can that happen accidentally?
Like, say you brush up against the table and you think, oh.
A little souge. It's not really an accident, but I'm enjoying myself. Ladies and gentlemen, Josie Long. Okay, so Sean and Rhod have 17. John and Kevin have 17. And here's your teaser. The words are piss tool, and the clue is it'll help it grow. That's piss tool. It'll help it grow. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were piss tool, and the clue was it'll help it grow. It was, of course, topsoils. OK, before we move on, it's time to welcome Rachel's assistant, Jo Wilkinson.
Why am I wearing a headset? It's because I've been promoted to head of IT. I've got a bit of a pay rise, so I sort of decided to spend a bit of extra cash on having four hunky guys carry me about. And I also bought a new suit, but unfortunately, I completely misjudged the length of my legs. All right, boys, off you pop. I met them down the allotment. Dressed like that, weirdos.
Joe, you mentioned being promoted to head of IT.
Prove it to you. Yeah, I got promoted head of IT. I don't really know what that means. But I've been told I've got to add a bit of gadgets and technology to the show because it's shit. So, like, I've done a few. They've got, like, an app. I've got a countdown app, done that. It's just a few pictures of Rachel and Susie in the shower. And, I've also done the old email and Facebook. Already got an email from Nick Hewer, the proper host, you know, the good one. And he said he thinks he's left some of it under the desk. So can you? He asked you if you could check.
Would it be? Is that?
Oh, great! Yeah, he's got it.
That's a My Little Pony lunchbox. Is that?
I'll tell him you've got it. Let's play countdown.
Okay, on with the game. John and Kevin, your turn to choose the letters.
Your honours, John. Oof. I've run out of fish.
This is the next big thing, mate. You mark my words. This what? Is kale, spinach, blueberries, and mackerel.
So. Is the mackerel swimming in it? It's like a very unhygienic pond.
It is the future, is what it is. I will pick 9 consonants and I'll still get a 12-letter word. Right, consonant, please.
Oh, by the way, if you don't like some of the letters coming out, you could buy a couple off me.
I'll have a consonant, please.
F.
And I'll have a vowel, please.
Oh.
And I'll have another consonant, please.
There's no shitting Wi-Fi.
Another consonant, please.
K.
John?
Kevin.
Brilliant. Me and you, we're out now, we're fine.
Definitely get a backup plan. Anyway.
Hang on, there might be an S.
What? Sforts a fork?
Nope.
Can I have another consonant, please?
Yeah! I did a trick.
And another vowel, please.
Why don't you just quit?
E.
And a consonant, please.
D.
Forked. This whole game is forked.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one. C.
And your time starts now. I got a tattoo. You want to see it, John?
Mm, it's a good one, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's nice.
What does it say?
It says, your mum. I was going to get one saying mum, but I thought your mum's nicer.
Well, not mine particularly, just anyone you meet.
And that's John's.
All right.
I'm glad you love my mum. She's a lovely lady.
What have you got? You all right, John?
It's not actually bad, this.
Yeah, it sounds good.
It's not so good on the way back.
Yeah, sure.
Can I just say, it's very, very difficult sitting here listening to this shit when you've got an eight.
Yeah. Have you got an eight?
I'm sitting here listening to you two prattle on, I'm thinking, I've got an eight.
Okay.
It's funny, I was distinctly under the impression that you got the eight while we were prattling on, but it's only a game. Shit, and all I've got is a fucking seven.
So, Sean?
I got nine.
You got nine?
And Kevin?
I've got three sixes, a five and two sevens. Probably stick one of the sevens in there.
Steve, what's your seven?
Do you ever, you're eating something, and then maybe you've got something in it, like maybe mushrooms that you don't like, and it ends up on your fork, and you need to sort of scrape it off, you defork the mushroom. And then you see you do it a few times, and it's plural, and he deforks. And people go, look at that guy the way he eats, he always deforks the mushroom.
Deforks? Susie, deforks.
Not Ian, but Kevin might kick himself in a minute.
Okay, John, next. What's your seven?
This is just a shout out to the guys who bring in my mackerel and my salmon. Dockers.
Okay. Rhod, you're eight.
Forsaked.
Forsaked.
Okay, Susie?
Forsook.
No, you can have either.
Forsaken.
No, you can have either. But all right, not... seven, forsake.
It's not
forsaked.
Oh, come forsaked. On.
Here, mate, do you want a drink?
Huh? Give me some of this.
Thanks, Bob.
Sean, your nine-letter word.
Dace forks.
Not
no, it's there.
Okay, well, that is 7 points to John. Josie, Susie, what could they have had?
We had an eight, but it's not a big deal for us. It's defrocks.
Not defrocks, but defrocks.
I know, but well, when's the last time you said I'm going to go and defrock?
It's people have got mushroom all over their dress.
There should be a.
So at the end of that, John and Kevin are in the lead with 24. Mm. On to another numbers round. Okay, Sean and Rhod, you're to make the numbers.
Out of the usual, please.
I'm just in the middle of Googling paving stones.
What are you Googling, Joe?
Pictures of paving stones for my spare bedroom.
You're having paving stones in your spare room?
No, pictures, you idiot.
Sorry, Joe.
Right, this numbers game, we've got seven.
That's
four,
a good, that's a good one.
Five. Eight.
That's going in a frame.
Two. 25 again. The target, 588.
Okay, your time starts now. Right, what have you got, John?
I think I've got 588.
Fabulous. OK, Kevin?
Yes, 588, 100%, definitely.
Sean?
Mood didn't take me.
Just started and I just went, no, not today.
OK, Rhod?
Well, I had a play around with Rachel's numbers there, and in the end, I found it easier to use different ones. So I've got 588.
But using your own methodology.
Yeah, 587 plus the one.
That's why you're the player you are. John, how did you do it?
I'll give it to the big man.
Give it to the big man. Sure.
All right. It's pretty no frills, Rachel, but we got there. It's 4 times 25, basic start.
4 25 is 100.
8 minus 2 is 6.
Yeah.
600. And then 7 plus 5 is...
Yeah, well done, 588.
10 points for Kevin and John. The scores at the moment, Sean and Rhod have 17, John and Kevin have 34. And here is your final teaser. The words are arse rash and the clue is get off my back. That's arse rash, get off my back. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were arse rash and the clue was get off my back. It was, of course, harasser. OK, time for our final letters game. Rhod, your turn to choose.
Vowel, please.
E.
Another vowel. Another vowel.
I. Speak up. A.
Congratulations, Rhod! This week's mystery prize. This week's mystery prize is a fencing panel. Congratulations, Rhod. That's your fencing panel. You're taking that home. That's safe. Unless, Rhod, you gamble. If you gamble, I'll ask you a question about fencing panels. If you get that question right, you will win another fencing panel. You will double your fencing panels. But if you get the question wrong, you lose all your fencing panels. So think carefully. Should he gamble? What are you going to do, Rhod?
I'm going to ignore the nose and I'm going to gamble.
He's
going
to gamble! You've gambled, and your question to double your fencing panels is... Which of these creosotes is best to use on a north-facing fencing panel in a garden that is prone to damp? Is it A, Bartolite's oil-based non-bio creosote, Creosil 500 dot wood preservative?
I know this.
Don't tell him, he's got to do it on his own show. This is Rhod's question. I'm going to have to hurry you for no particular reason.
I'm going to say A.
It's nice, Creosote 500! Take it away, boys! I'm sorry! He hasn't won any further. Let's play the countdown!
Rhod, if you Care to continue?
Pick yourself up, boy.
consonant, please.
Consonant?
Yeah.
L.
Another consonant, please.
H.
Another consonant, please.
M.
Another consonant, please.
Why?
Just me. Because. Another consonant, please.
T.
No, I'm right, thanks. another... No, actually, I'll have a vowel this time, actually, Rachel.
Just you.
OK, your time starts now. What have you got? Rhod. Rhod. Rhod.
Go to somebody else for a minute.
Kevin.
John or Sean, please.
John.
Nominate Rhod.
It's 30 seconds, come on!
I've got a 7.
You've got a 7. OK, Sean.
No. I've got a very cheeky, risky 4.
You've got a risky 4. Got a 4-letter word. OK. Kevin.
I've got a 5.
OK. Rhod?
I've got 8, but I'm very unhappy with the spelling.
Well, I can't help that, Rhod. I can't help that. I'm sorry. Kevin, what have you got?
I'm going to go for time, but as in, you know, crisps. T-H-Y-M-E.
As in the crisps. That is an insight into a Glaswegian's diet. You know, time, as in the crisps. Never...
I think they got the idea for the crisps from a food.
You know, fruit, as in fruit pastels. Sean, what was yours?
Tool. T-U-L-E, tool. Tool.
Tool. Susie, is that in the dictionary?
Not tool. That kind of tool.
You know, you need a tool like a hammer or a spanner. I need a tool for this job.
Rhod? I've got humidity, but I've spelled it H-M-T-Y.
Is that a Welsh thing?
It's just missing the D in the middle.
Step back and let a pro step in and save the show. Somebody who has a lot of money, is wealthy, someone who eats a lot of dinners, is mealthy. Mealthy. You're welcome. Let's move on. No need to check it. No need to check it.
No Mealthy, John. Sorry.
So the points there go to Kevin Bridges for time. 5 letters. Josie.
We just got a 6, which was Hamlet, like a little village.
OK. So Sean and Rhod have 17 points. John and Kevin have 39. Okay, fingers on buzzers. You're playing
Jimmy,
for dignity.
A woman there, not clapping. In the green top. She's not clapping. That's better. Just we've done well. We've been trying hard. Seen better countdowns. I've been to some of the legendary episodes, and this is just not up to scratch.
Okay.
Don't wear a green jumper and not clap. That's what I'm saying. If you're not going to clap, wear a brown jumper like the fella in front.
Yes, green, famously not a good colour for camouflage.
Yeah. Not in a TV studio, Jimmy, actually. Mr. I could very so quickly say something which people might laugh at.
OK, fair point.
Thank you.
Fingers on buzzers, time for today's Countdown Conundrum. What have you got?
Well, I've pressed quickly because I've got A word and I don't think it's A word, but I've got... oh, no.
OK, start the clock again.
done it again. Another week, he's done it! He's only...
Rob, what have you got?
He's only paintings, boys, paintings. He's done it again!
So, let's have a look.
Losing in style. Yeah. So the final scores are Sean and Rhod have 27, but tonight's winners with 39, John and Kevin. Congratulations, fancy dressing gowns. Look at that. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Cameron Diaz is out to seduce Justin Timberlake. Quite an education. Our comedy movie, Bad Teacher, is this Sunday at 9. Next tonight, from shark cat to real-life line-drawing baby, Rude Tube compiles 100 of the funniest and downright stupidest things on the internet last year.